Hey guys, welcome back to Wisdom Tooth. I hope you guys are safe during this pandemic. And as promised last time, today we'll be taking another set of questions that that we one need to answer during an interview, and we'll try and figure out the correct way to answer these questions. So let's begin with the video. There are two questions that I'll be talking in this video. The first one is, why should we hire you? And the second question is, why do you want to be a part of this company, or why us? So I'll be taking both the questions one at a time and try and discuss the correct answer to these. Now before any interview, one thing one must do all the time is do the research, like the background research. Now what I really mean by background research is, so you have your interview the next day. What I want you to do is, you should go to the company's website, you visit the company's website, and you try and accumulate all the knowledge that you can about the company, such as questions such as what's the name of the company for starters, then followed by when was it established, where is it headquartered at, what are the major products and services that it is catering, and who are the major the competitors in the market. And finally, the what is the future vision of the company? What is the future objective of the company? Now, once you've done your research, what I really want you to do is, you need to map your skills with that of the company's objective. So for instance, let's take an example wherein I am applying to a company which is into medical devices, and I have worked or have an academic qualification about say market analysis and forecasting. So how I answer this question? So I'll say, I can say something like this: I have done my research about the company, and I know for a fact that the company is struggling in European and USA market against its major competitors like Siemens and Johnson & Johnson. What I can do for the company is, I can do, as per my academic qualification or my knowledge and my learnings, my skills of market analysis and forecasting can be put to good use by, I can help the company in strategizing product developments in these markets. Now, what I will get from the company as a return of this is, I can learn about project management and consultation from this organization. So one of the question is done. Now the next question is, why should we hire you? Now in this question too, instead of the skills, you should map your strengths, like the personality strengths or the personality traits that you have, with what the company or the team that you're applying for is looking for, or how your key strength areas can help the company. So if someone asked me, why should we hire you? Like, we have n number of candidates who have been interviewed or who are waiting to be interviewed, why you? So my answer would be something like this. I can say that I cannot really comment on the people that you've already interviewed or that you are going to be interviewing for the next couple of days, but I can definitely speak about my own strengths and my skills. Now I believe that this is something that only I as an individual can offer you. Going to my work ethics and my smart working attitude, I will make sure that I can get your work done and the project delivered in the stipulated time. And also my understanding of client relationship will help in boosting the clientele or the client base that you already have or you are eyeing on in near future. Now also, because I have managed the role of managing n number of individuals in my previous organization, I believe my leadership skills can come into act and will help not just me but the team and the organization in the longer run to achieve its objectives, the end goals. So basically what I am doing is, I am mapping my strengths with that of the company's or the team's objective. So in both the questions, what you want to do is, you have to answer what you can offer to the organization, also what the organization can offer to you, because this is not an NGO that you're applying to. This is a job. You'll be getting paid for the job. So for getting paid for the job, you have to give something to the company. And the company, and also not just the money, monetary terms is important, but it is not the only thing for a job. The next thing that you want to acquire is some kind of a learning or some kind of a position that you're eyeing at. So you need to mention that. So with this we come to the end of the video. In the next video I'll be discussing the next question, that is how to answer your weakness, you know, in an interview. So people tend to ask you what are your weaknesses and how to put it in words so that it doesn't really hinder your success. Now in case you have any suggestions or comments, please put that in the comment section, and please like, share and subscribe to Wisdom Tooth. Thank you so much.